Welcome back to Coach's Corner live on Madison's Hilltop. I'm Tim Torrance. Thanks for tuning us in this morning. Again, we do it every Saturday morning from McDonald's here across from the Madison High School. Of course, spring sports is our topic, and more specifically, we're going to talk to Shaw Girls Tennis with Coach Steven Sims, and we got some players in. We'll talk with them a little bit later on in the program as they finish eating. Steve, good morning to you.
Morning, Tim. How are you?
I'm good. And you?
Doing good.
Life is good?
It's, you know, living the dream.
Every day.
Absolutely.
Every day. Tennis season is upon us, and guys off to a good start. We'll kind of talk about the season in just a little bit. Let's go back and reflect on a year ago, an outstanding season for the tennis team.
It was. You know, let's see, this year is my eighth year coaching. Last year, seventh year, and, you know, we started my first year at one win, and the goal was always, you know, more, get a couple more each year, and it kept, you know, every year we were able to do that, and then last year we were able to, I think we lost maybe two matches all year, and we were end up winning the first sectional in school history. So it was a good year last year, and then we're hoping to just capitalize on that this year. So
what was the what's the key to success from last year? What was it for this team?
Keeping the same people. To be honest, we only lost one player from our top seven last year, and we're able to replace her pretty well. So we've got, we've got the same crew coming back, and it's just dedication. I mean, hard work. I mean, you know, these girls have been playing for a while, and they keep playing and keep getting better, and they're able to, you know, want to get better. You know, yesterday, prime example, I had everything, being the athletic director also, I had everything going on and was running back and forth between baseball, softball, and all that, and just said, look, girls, you got an hour, you got to play tennis. Mm-hmm. And I wasn't able to be at practice, wasn't able to work with them, but I looked every now and then, and they're doing it. They're out there trying to get better and doing what I tell them to do. So that's a good thing, you know, and that's that says a lot. So
you know, you have the same people coming back, and that certainly does help. But even those same people, and I mean, you're going to reload with new kids every year, but you still have them coming back. They still have to want to get better, and apparently that's happening.
Yeah, it is, and that's a good thing about it. I mean, they all know, you know, what we did last year, and they want to do it again this year, but they know that you can't just expect that it's going to happen. You have to keep working for it, and they've been able to do that so far. You know, we had a rocky match a couple days ago, but we're still able to win 5-0. So if you look at the scores, it looks like, hey, we won easily, but we were struggled, and we were able to hang in there and keep it up to end up winning the match. And that shows, you know, grit and determination that you don't always see, and that's what we have on our team. So that's
good. You look at this team especially, and I mean, with experience coming back, you're going to have those matches where things just don't particularly roll your way, but those players that have the drive and desire to win will find a way to make it happen.
Yeah, that was you know, and that happened a couple times last year, and this year, you know, our first four or five matches, we kind of, you know, we won. Yeah. We'll put it that way, and there wasn't big challenges very much, but then the other night, you know, we were down, three matches, went to three sets, and all of them lost the first set, and they all came back and won the next two sets, and that's showing that, you know, you don't give up, and sometimes I see it in sports, in high school sports, you get down a couple runs and you're like, ah, we're done. And, you know, baseball, or you get down in tennis, or you get down in whatever, and you just give up. But for us, they didn't, and that's the important thing. And I don't think they will. And I see them in practice and see them in matches, and we don't give up, and I'm proud of that, and that's a good thing for us going forward.
You pick up a sectional championship a year ago. Got to be pretty exciting.
It was. It was very exciting. That was all of my goal. You know, I tease because my 8 years ago, I said if I ever win a sectional, I'm not going to coach anymore. But here I am. But my wife loves that. But yeah. But you know, I mean, with everybody coming back and everything, it's good to be back and go for it again. You know, you think you get to a goal, and that's what we've been talking about for 8 years, winning a sectional, and then finally do it, and it's like, oh, let's try to get another one. So we're excited about the opportunity.
You getting a little greedy?
I guess so. I sound like it. I don't mean to sound like it, but it's just, you know, once you win, you just want to keep winning, I guess.
Yeah. Well, and you look at where you came from 8 years ago to now, and how much progression this program has made, it's got to make a coach feel pretty good.
It does. It's great. And I mean, part of it is having athletes and having talent, sure. But also, you know, I had, you know, we have a junior high program now that we've had for 4 or 5 years, maybe longer than that. I'm not sure exactly. But when I started, we didn't have that. I had two girls on a 13, with 13 girls on the team, two of them never played tennis. So we won one match and we thought we won the Super Bowl when we won that match. So now we're to where we don't want to lose matches, right. And we expect to go out and compete every time. And it's nice to go from one end to the other. So
you. That mentality is difficult to change once you start out trying to win matches and then getting into the mentality of now we've won, now we don't want to lose. That's not something that happens overnight, and it's not something that you essentially can teach kids. That's something they have to want themselves.
Yeah, they do. And they have to realize it and not, you know, A, they don't want to go in thinking that they're, you know, okay, we've won, now we're not going to lose. And then B, it's you don't want to get back to, oh my, we're going to lose this match. You know, you've seen a lot with high school kids, you know, going into matches or going into any sporting event, you know, maybe nerves, maybe, you know, oh, we're playing this good team, what are we going to do against them? But we don't seem to do that. We seem to be ready for each match, and, you know, we might talk about it, you know, who we're playing and what we're going to have to do to beat them and stuff right. like that, but we don't get scared or anything, which means the confidence level has built up, so that's good.
Yeah, and that is good. Talking Shaw Tennis with Coach Steve Sims. We'll come back and talk about this season right after this from McDonald's. It's Coach's Corner here on WORX 96.7. Welcome back to Coach's Corner live on Madison's Hilltop. I'm Tim Torrance. Thanks for tuning us in this morning. Again, we do it every Saturday morning from McDonald's here across from the Madison High School, talking Shaw Girls Tennis this morning with Coach Steve Sims. And Coach, we mentioned the at the beginning of the program, started out with an excellent season this year, off to a good start, and talk about it.
Yeah, we'll see. We've played played five matches so far. We should have played eight. We've got three rained out, and you know, the weather's always interesting. But we've done pretty well so far. We've like I said, we've won five matches, and we, you know, the other night we had a real test against New Washington. They always seem to give us fits, no matter how good they are or how good we are. Ever since I've been coaching, it's always a battle with them. So, you know, we had some struggles, but then we were able to overcome them. But we've been playing pretty well. But you know, there's going to be tougher competition on the schedule. There's going to be things that are coming up that we got to be prepared for. And I think we are. But so far, it's going pretty well.
You look at the success so far early in the season, and you know, as it goes, it's going to get more difficult. Is it good to start off, I don't want to say with easy matches, but the way you've started, and then ramp up your level of competition as you progress through the season?
I don't know. You know, it's in the schedule. You know, in high school sports, you never know what you're going to be facing. Right. So, you know, the schedule 1 year is going to be, you're playing all the teams are in the beginning of the schedule really good, and then the other year they're not, and then the other year they're, it just, you never know.
Right.
The same teams were, you know, really, really good, you know, years ago, and they're still nothing. They're still good now.
Right.
So it's just, I don't know. We just got to go out and play every match and know that we can win it, but, you know, not be overconfident and just go out and do what we're supposed to do, no matter who we're playing.
You talk about the weather. How much does that affect you guys' play?
Tennis is a little tricky with weather as far as the wind. The wind can affect the ball greatly compared to other sports. So the nice thing about it, if it rains, the courts will dry pretty quickly. But as far as playing the game, the wind is the biggest factor. If you have a lot of wind, it can alter the ball and stuff like that. But, you know, we've got we're getting to where we're understanding. I think we talked to myself and my assistant coach, Chris Hill. We talked to him about, you know, where to play, how to face your back to the wind, and, you know, things like that. But it's not going to always work. They just got to go out and play. And sometimes the ball is going to go in crazy places when the wind gets a hold of it, and you just got to adjust to it. So
well, it kind of brings me to my next question, what I was going to ask. You play the wind? you adjust yourself to play the wind?
A little. Mm-hmm. I mean, you try, but again, these are, you know, high school girls, so it's not always like you're not going to say, hey, this wind's coming from the southeast, and, you know, they're not going to know what you're talking about. So you just have to adjust the best you can. And you know, after a couple shots and you see, okay, the ball's going to be coming this way from the wind, then you can adjust yourself. Here's where I know this ball's going to be coming, but you don't always know where a ball's going to be coming in tennis, that's for sure anyway. Yeah. So, yes, little adjustments, but you just got to still go out and play. So.
Numbers-wise, pretty good.
Is that a trick question? No, we're doing good.
Promise it's not.
We're doing good. We've got 12 girls right now, so we've got 5 playing JV, and they've been battling also. Our JV matches have been going well, and like I said, I contributed to the junior high program. They play in junior high. They play 2 years, and they want to keep playing tennis, and they love tennis, so they keep playing it, and it's a great transition for them. So,
and as we talked earlier, you talk about numbers and where you were at 8 years ago compared to where you're at now with numbers with varsity and JV and junior high, and that's what helps refill your program year after year is coming up from the lower level.
It is, and Steve Hesse, Lisa Hesse, Natalie Hill, and Chris Hill, they've all kind of started the program and kept it going, and Natalie and Lisa are coaching right now the junior high program, and it's amazing. Mm-hmm. Because I remember that first year I had to go and explain what 30 love meant and what the lines were, and I mean every single thing about the game of tennis to my team, and you're at the varsity level, and it's like, I shouldn't be doing this at the varsity level. Right. And now I really don't.
Right.
I don't really go over rules unless somebody comes and asks me something, because they know. They've been playing. They know the game. And it's easy now. We work on getting better instead of how to play the game. And it's a big difference. It is.
Yeah, and that's again, talking about that and doing that, then your focus when you get things rolling every spring can be a little bit different, and other than trying to teach them the basics of the game.
Yeah, we work more on strategies and work more on different types of shots and putting the ball down the line and cross courts and, you know, all sorts of stuff that I did not have the luxury of doing, you know, years ago. It was just, how do you hit a forehand? And so it's great. I mean, it does make a huge difference.
Talk about how many seniors you have.
We have 3 seniors. Seniors, just one with us here today, but the other two skipped out on me. But now we have 3 seniors, and they have played. I think all of them have played for 4 years. So and they've helped build the program. Our 1 and 2 singles are both seniors. Claire Higgins and Megan Hill, and then Carson Hambrick's playing number 2 doubles, and she's been playing as well. And it's big to have them on the team because they know how things work, and they're good leaders.
So. Talk about do we 3 seniors, but talk about the rest of your team as far as how they size up by class.
Class wise, I've got juniors. Who are they? They're Megan Hesse, who's here. Uh-huh. She plays number 1 doubles, and then Katrina Gobert and Chloe Lee is a JV player.
All the juniors.
That's all the juniors. If you ask me, like, in order, I could do it, like, as far as what they play. But classes. Sophomores, we have Kate Grody, who showed up today. I'm glad. She's sitting next to me. And then who else do we have? Caden Hambrick is right on the edge of our lineup. She is the number 8 player in the lineup, plays number 1 singles for JV, and is, I mean, a good player, works hard. Kelly Hesse is another sophomore. And she works hard as well. I mean, all these girls work hard. Is that all sophomores? Freshman Olivia Kelly has jumped in the lineup and plays number 2 doubles for us. And Destiny Stivers and Caroline Grody. That's it.
All right.
That's it. I hope I don't get any phone calls.
You
later.
Did a nice job.
But I think I've got them all. But anyway, that's our lineup. But like I said, we've got Claire playing number 1, Megan Hill at number 2, Katrina playing number 3, Kate and Megan at number 1 doubles, and Olivia and Carson at number 2 doubles. So it's a nice lineup, and then the rest of the girls work hard as well, and they're a good group to have around.
Is that a pretty set lineup for you? match in and match out?
Pretty much. Mm-hmm. We have a challenge ladder that has yet to be challenged, mm-hmm. but if they want to move up a spot, then that's up to them. Yeah. So they can challenge somebody to take their spot, but that is yet to happen. But, you know, if it happens, it happens. But right now, that's pretty much set, and they've you know, doubles is important too, because you have to be able to play well mm-hmm. with your partner. You can't, I mean, I don't want to just throw somebody in with somebody else and them not play together. So even if they challenge, I might tweak that a little bit, because right. it might not work. But right now, the two doubles teams we have, I think, are doing pretty well, and they work well together. So,
Coach, you mentioned three seniors. I know, as every coach knows, seniors are, everybody's valuable, seniors especially.
Yes, they are. And like I said, all these seniors have played all 4 years, and I think even, you know, played in junior high, and I know for sure two of them did. And it's just, they love tennis, and they want to keep getting better, and most of them play other sports as well, and right. they want to get better at that. And it's just, you know, at Shaw, you got to play everything, but they've done it. They're loyal to the teams and loyal to their school, and we appreciate that very much.
And that's, you know, and that's you always ask a lot of your seniors to come in, and you know, you want them to play well, but with that, they've got to be a leader. Sometimes that leadership role is a little easier than others for some. Some it's not, and you just got to roll with the punches with some.
Yeah, absolutely. And they've all, you know, it's funny. I look at it, some of them when they were freshmen to when they were seniors, and how, you know, they evolved from, you know, being quiet and shy to being, like, in charge. And, yeah. and it has. It's happened, and it's nice to see. And not only are they doing that, but then they're going out and performing and executing on the court as well. So it's nice, and the younger players look up to them and listen to them, and where, you know, I might not be at everywhere, and sometimes they have to listen to one of the seniors say, hey, we got to get this started or whatever, and they do that, and they do it pretty well, so it's good.
It is good. Claire, you're up. Good morning.
Good morning.
Your last hurrah on Coach's Corner.
Yeah, I know. So bittersweet.
I know what it's sad. It's sad. I'm sure I've asked you this before. I'm going to ask you again. Why'd you take up tennis?
Well, it seemed fun, and all my friends did it.
Yeah. Is it fun?
Yeah, it is fun.
You're a very competitive player in whatever you play. Is this? How does this relate to basketball or volleyball?
Oh, I'm 100% more competitive in tennis.
Yeah.
Because it's like all on me, so I get more angry with myself. But other than that, I mean, I'm competitive all around.
Yeah. Number one, singles, any pressure to do that?
I mean, yeah, but it's just as much pressure as any other spot.
Yeah. What's the key to success in tennis for you?
So many keys.
So little time.
I don't know, just not getting down, because it's easy to do, especially if you're on singles and just playing by yourself. Yeah. So.
Do you have a weakness in tennis you need to improve on?
Probably how I start out, because every single match I've started out horribly, so just getting that better.
Get off to a better start.
Yeah.
Yeah. Goals for you as a senior for this team?
Definitely sectionals.
Mm-hmm. And then beyond?
Yes, because we did not do so great in regionals last year. So.
What will it take to be successful then in regional?
Just the mindset we have, really.
Yeah. Going to IU?
Yes.
Studying?
Definitely.
Something?
Yes. Studying, marketing, and then, gosh, what's it called? Media advertising. I'm going to tie to double major.
Are you now?
Yeah.
That'll be fun.
Let's hope.
Let's hope so. Best of luck. Thanks for being here.
Thank you.
All right. Megan, good morning.
Good morning.
Why are you involved in tennis?
My parents have both always, like, played tennis. And so, like, when my mom was, like, my junior high coach, so they, like, got me involved. And, like, all of my friends played, too. So it was just, like, an easy way to get me to play.
Yeah. Do you... You're like everybody else, you're a multi-sport athlete. Is tennis, how is it different from volleyball to basketball?
I think it's kind of the same still, but it's more like personal. Like, even though I play like doubles and it's just me and my partner, it's still more like we have to like get our thing done and just do it. And yeah.
Doubles, tough thing to play?
Sometimes it is, because you have to like work with that other person a lot and like, yeah.
Good communication?
Yes.
Is it always good?
Most of the time it's good. There's some little fights and arguments, but for the most part it's pretty good and we're solid.
And Kate's your partner?
Yes, Kate is my partner.
Keys to success for this team?
I would say us like working together and like staying calm and making sure that we like execute every single point.
Possibility for another sectional?
Yes, I think definitely, and hopefully maybe we can even go farther, but that's, we'd have to like try hard and really focus to get that.
Yeah, and that's kind of what I was going to ask you, was what would the focus have to be at regional to get past that point?
Have to be us like coming out ready to play and like playing hard every single point in the whole game to be able to get it done.
What do you two do well as a team?
I think we are both like quick and can get to a lot of balls that don't seem like we can, and we can just like get it back, keep it in play, and hit it hard when we need to.
And you guys need to work on what to get better?
Maybe a little bit of communication and just playing together.
Yeah. All right. Thanks for being here this morning.
Thank you.
All right. Kate, good morning.
Hello.
Why do you play tennis?
I love my friends.
Yeah?
Yeah.
You just play because they play?
Yeah.
You like tennis?
I like Mr. Sims. He's pretty cool.
Wow. Compliment for the coach.
Hey, I'll take it.
That's a plus this morning.
I'll take it.
Doubles, I would think doubles would be tough because there's got to be a whole lot of communication and understanding and a lot of non-communication, just understanding to play together.
Yeah, there's a lot. I think Megan's really good at the back row, and I'm definitely like up at the front hitting the easy ones.
Yeah.
She can have all the hard ones.
You like playing up close to the net?
Yeah, I like watching people.
Yeah. Do you like slam it hard back over?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All the time.
All the time.
Sometimes I'll just hit it really short when they're all back and they think I'm going to hit it hard.
Ah.
Psych.
Yeah, that's good. What about for you? What do you think you're going to have to do as a team to be successful?
Definitely like start out to a good start, like Claire said, because like in New Wash, we all dropped the first set.
Mm-hmm.
So just starting out strong.
But when you drop the first set, nobody panics. Everybody just forges ahead.
No, it's more like, oh crap.
Yeah.
Get it together.
Gotta play.
Yeah.
Gotta play. Sectional title, pretty possible for this team?
Definitely.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, like regionals is not far away if we try really hard.
Effort and understanding. And okay, what's your best part of playing with your partner?
Honestly, Megan's probably like my best friend, so it's fun. We get to like yell at each other, and sometimes I really don't take anything she says seriously, so her reactions, and I always make fun of how she hits the ball. Yeah. It's pretty funny.
What's something you need to work on together?
I need to work on my back row. We probably need to be more serious because, you know, I just always laugh at her. She's pretty funny.
I can only imagine. Thanks, Kate, for being here.
Anytime.
All right. Olivia, good morning.
Good morning.
Why tennis for you?
Well, I needed something to do in the spring, and I don't like sitting at home all the time, so that's kind of why I started tennis, just to get out of the house, have something to do.
And you like it?
Yes, I ended up loving it.
So. Yeah. You're a three-sport athlete, too.
Yeah.
What's the difference in basketball, volleyball, and tennis?
Basketball and volleyball are more of a team sport because you're with a lot more people, but like I play doubles, so it's just me and Carson.
Mm-hmm.
So it's more of a personal game, even though I'm not by myself. Mm-hmm. But yeah, that's probably just the only difference, is more personal.
As a freshman coming in to play varsity, has it been a little overwhelming?
Kind of, but volleyball is more overwhelming because that was my first varsity sport that I played.
Mm-hmm.
And so I'm kind of getting used to it now, but it's definitely a challenge. I feel like I definitely have to try my best, work hard, come out and execute all the time.
You and Carson work well together?
I'd say so. We both get along really well.
Yeah. What's the biggest challenge playing doubles?
just you have to be on your toes all the time, because like if you hit it to a front row person, they can put it, place it somewhere very easily. So you just have to know that you have to move fast and figure out where you're going.
Is there something you guys need to work on together to make yourself better?
I'd say, yeah, personally, my back row playing, I'm not an awesome back row player, but like up at the net, I'd say I do pretty good.
Yeah.
But it's just ground strokes probably I need to work on the most.
You jumped on a team that was a sectional champion last year. Now you're going to try to make them a sectional champion this year. How hard will that be for you as a freshman?
It's really nerve-wracking, but I mean, as long as we go out there and we all play our best, we all execute, we're all doing what we know how to do, then I think we can do it.
Best of luck.
Thank you.
All right. Pretty good group.
They are. They are. And they're fun to be around, too.
I can only imagine.
You know, after driving, you know, a minibus full of girls, as now you know also, it can be interesting, you know, them singing and everything. And at first it's like, you know, but now it's, you know, it's part of how it goes.
Right.
And they're fun to be around. And not only are they fun, but then when they get on the court, then they're ready to play. And they're ready to take care of business. So
that's good that when they walk on the court, they know. And as they've talked about, you know, as Kate mentioned, we dropped the first match, but now we got to play.
Yeah, absolutely. And you know, that was, you know, I've seen before where players lose a match or lose the first set, and then they go, Kate said, before would say, oh, and then give up.
Right.
We say, oh man, what did we do?
Yeah.
And we get it together and win the next two sets,
right,
which is a total different mentality. And it's nice to see, because they could easily just say, well, I already lost, I'm done. And they don't. And that's a big difference. So.
You kind of, let's look before we wrap it up, look ahead, what's coming up for this team and what's going to have to happen.
I'm the AD. I should know the schedule, right? We play, I don't know. We play Trinity Lutheran this week. That's all I know. And I know that the end of next week, we have our conference tournament.
Right.
So that is always a goal. You know, before each season, we set that we're going to win our conference tournament, we're going to win sectional, and that's the goals, and we talk about them. Oh, there's the schedule. Trinity Lutheran, Lanesville. That's a busy week. We got Trinity Lutheran, Lanesville, and Henryville next week, and the conference tournament.
Yeah.
So a busy week. I don't know much about Lanesville. We've played Trinity Lutheran and Henryville for the last however many years. But And I don't, you know, but we've got to be ready to play either way. But so we've got that, and then that conference tournament, always nice to win. Christian Academy is not going to be in it this year, so it's going to be, you know, a little different. We'd like to play them. We were supposed to play them Thursday.
Right.
I've got rained out. That's a team we've been trying to beat for a couple years now, and so it'd be nice to play them. I'm not sure if we're going to get that rescheduled. But anyway, we got to be ready. We've got busy weeks ahead, and you know, tennis sectionals is a week earlier than every other sectional, so we really only have like 3 weeks or so before sectionals start, so it's coming sooner than you think, and you got to go out and just execute in every match leading up to it and be ready.
It's kind of a redundancy to say you need to be playing your best tennis, because you guys are playing some good tennis, but if you're going to save the better tennis for the end of the season, might be a good idea.
Yeah, absolutely. It's nice to start out well, but it doesn't matter if you don't do well at the end. So we got to be playing well the entire season, and I think we will. I think we're good for that. I want to mention somebody real quick,
sure,
because I forgot earlier. My manager, Mackenzie Ott, she played what she played her freshman year, and she thinks she's no good. I think she's not bad, but she thinks she's no good. But she really liked being around us all, I guess.
Right.
It's probably me, like, you know, the reason Kate's playing. But anyway, but she wanted to come back, and she's been helping a lot. The other day, she wasn't there at the match at New Wash, and I was lost.
Yeah.
Because she does everything for me on match day. So I got to mention her, because I didn't earlier.
All right.
There you go.
Well, Mr. Sims, we appreciate you being on this morning. It's been an enlightening experience, as always.
Absolutely.
And you guys have great success already, and I know you'll have great success the rest of the season.
We hope so. Thank you very much for having us.
All right. Again, that's Coach Steve Sims and the Shaw tennis team, Kate Grody, Claire Higgins, Megan Hesse, Olivia Kelly. See, right off the top of my head, I got them all. Oh, that's great. Thanks for joining us this morning for Coach's Corner. We'll be back with it next week, right here at 9 a.m., live from the McDonald's on Madison's Hilltop. Until then, I'm Tim Torrance on WORX 96.7.